special emergency parliamentary session. It is because of our concern that this issue must galvanize support all Malaysians, regardless of their political affiliations. Number two is a lack of information. In fact, in the first few days, we had more information out of Manila than out of Malaysia, out of Lahad Datu in the related area. And it's of course disconcerting because we have a problem here. It's caused a lot of anguish, anxiety, and concern among Sabahans who fear for their lives and their safety and security. It is a duty, if I rise on that, any established authority or government to protect and defend our homeland and security. So we need to have this engagement of parliament. In fact, I extended beyond that by asking Prime Minister Najib to invite Minister of Defense, Minister of Home Affairs, and political party leaders for a roundtable discussion. He can even close doors if he wants to, if he believes that some information did not be made public. And how is it handled? I mean, of course, firstly, I've offered my condolences. I've thanked the police personnel and police. but you must appreciate the fact that 24 hours before the army went in, we had called, while supporting the police initiative, called for the government to deploy the armed forces and leave it to them for their professional expertise without political interference. That we need. Of course, this has been quite protracted. As I said, this is not a war against the Zulus. This is a battle, swift, tough, against armed insurgents. And I think for the government, and I believe the Pakatan Rakyat position, when we take over the government, we make it very clear, we will not tolerate nor condone any militant exercise that would compromise the security of our country. But this is not a battle against the Zulus, because vast majority of the Zulus are peace-loving people, loyal to Malaysia, and must be considered as our loyal citizens.
From what you have heard so far, would you say that yesterday's military operation was a failure or was botched?
Well, it is a success in so far that it was able to swiftly resolve the initial conflict. But a lot of questions have been raised because we don't find the incidents. Was there some negotiations prior to that? What happened? But this is where a problem arising out of the fact that you censor and control the media. And of course, I've been getting lots of information out of Manila. The media is relatively free. You can see this huge disconnect between what's reported here and what is reported in the Philippines. What, unfortunately, the UMNO media wants to do is just to portray the opposition as part of this having complicity in the aggression. I mean, just to investigate, to accuse me of being an agent of the Sultan of Sulu. I mean, too many agents already. But the point is, it is pathetic to have a national problem, a national security problem, and you have the mainstream media, the UMNO media, and UMNO leaders trying to deflect this, to show their incompetence, their slow reaction, the failure of the Prime Minister, Minister of Defense, the Home Affairs, to respond even with a clear statement by just casting aspersions on the rest.